Chris, and this may sound counter to the hero thing, but he's a great villain. He was a great villain in Death Trap, you know.
I've always believed that an actor should never judge the character that he's playing. That allows you to play somebody evil or somebody with values that aren't the same as yours, and it really frees you as an actor.
He had to choose between doing the soap opera and making some nice money and getting some camera training or going back for his last year at school. He took the soap.
With the income from the soap, Chris was able to pursue another lifelong passion, his love of flying.
When I was in my stroller, I would get whiplash from looking at the planes going overhead. I've always been fascinated with flying.
Earning his pilot's license at 21, Chris spent many hours in the air. He shared his enthusiasm with another friend from acting class.
It was very quickly afterwards that we became very good friends, had the same interests. Both of us had a very passionate interest in aviation.
His Broadway success was followed by the movie version of Death Trap. Co-starring with Michael Caine, Chris played a young psychopath.
Why are you burning it? There's nothing incriminating.
Still, I'll say I was getting rid of manuscripts as the Grim Reaper struck.
The less you say to the truth, the better.
Farewell, Death Trap. Would that you were the genuine article. I really am going to try something on ESP. That was an awfully impressive demonstration the lady gave, despite the mistakes. Now, I'm going to make the call now, so you go and get your things.
Well, how long do you think you're going to be?
Well, at least 2 hours. I may have to go with her, I don't know.
Well, ciao.
Ciao. Oh, Cliff, the floorboards upstairs creak, so do a quick wash up, get into bed, and stay there.
I'll buy that.
Are they using diabolical subterfuge to shove gay propaganda down the throats of our children? No one likes to be manipulated by Hollywood and liberal elites, but that's how many X-Men fans feel when they find out that X-Men director Bryan Singer, who stands accused of pedophilia and child rape, has used the series to indoctrinate young boys into a gay lifestyle. X-Men director Bryan Singer allegedly met his accuser Michael Egan, then 15, in 1998 at a mansion in Encino, California. Tragically, that was a site of regular drug-fueled underage sex attacks and pedophilia. Michael Egan, who was 15 years old at the time, sued X-Men director and writer Bryan Singer for allegedly raping and molesting him. Egan describes a network of Hollywood homosexuals engaged in pedophilia. He stated that X-Men director Bryan Singer claimed that these gay men run Hollywood.
Had me over to the house of where these perpetrators in this ring kind of basically started. They'd pull me away for their threat sessions and tell me they have gaydar, they have this. At the end of the day, if you don't keep the members of this group happy, we control Hollywood. We can eliminate you. We will eliminate you. Threat after threat after threat. I was raped numerous times in that house by numerous individuals. Various types of sexual abuse all throughout that house. It was just something that you were like a piece of meat to these people, and they'd pass you around between them. It was, if I could define what that house was, it's evil.
Incredibly, just days before the singer suit was to go to court, famous child actor Corey Feldman talked to Nightline about how he and other child actors were raped by Hollywood elite, and that many of those who are running Hollywood are in fact pedophiles, and the dirtiest secret is pedophilia.
I can tell you that the number one problem in Hollywood was and is and always will be pedophilia. That's the biggest problem for children in this industry.
The casting couch even applies to children.
Oh yeah. Not in the same way. It's all done under the radar.
Nobody talks about pedophilia.
It's the big secret.
And it's widespread?
Oh yeah. I was surrounded by them when I was 14 years old. Surrounded. Literally. Didn't even know it. It wasn't until I was old enough to realize what they were and what they wanted and what they were about and the types of people that were surrounding me till I went, oh my God, they were everywhere like vultures.
Vultures who Feldman says abused him and his best friend, the late child actor Corey Haim, his co-star in The Lost Boys.
Well, what happens if my mom is dating the head vampire?
Feldman says the trauma of that pedophilia contributed to Haim's death.
There's one person to blame in the death of Corey Haim, and that person happens to be a Hollywood mogul. And that person needs to be exposed, but unfortunately I can't be the one to do it. But the person that knows who did it and knows who he is watching right now, I guarantee you.
And Madison stated that a main tactic of subversion was to, quote, portray gays as victims of circumstance and oppression, not as aggressive challengers. Gays must be portrayed as victims in need of protection so that straights will be inclined by reflex to assume the role of protector, end quote.
In the 90s, Chris began to take another of his interests more seriously, competitive horseback riding. Saturday, May 27th began well. However, as he galloped toward the third jump, his horse, Buck, suddenly stopped short and Chris was thrown from his horse.
I came straight down on the top rail of the jump, hyperextended my neck and slumped down in a heap. Head first, 6 feet 4 inches and 215 pounds of me. Straight down on the rail. Within seconds, I was paralyzed and not breathing.